senior All-American, number one, Jaylen Hands.
Interesting to see how the lack of depth affects him early. Great pass by Jaylen. Switch. Just beautiful. Oh, that's what they want. Woo! Still by Nafferet. Nafferet out to Hands. Oh, no. That is a pro. And Foothills is now running them out of the gym. Pick and roll. That fist. Good finish. Going pick and roll again. Good defense, but a beautiful pull up. My. I think the kids say that he is in his bag right now. Dancing. Pull up. Two. Technical foul. Watch that flare.
Talking with somebody just about, you know, some of the changes that you've had in your life, you know, going from modern day Catholic, spending a year in the prep system at Balboa Prep, and now coming back for your final year in Foothills Christian. What were some of the lessons that you learned along the way that have, you know, helped you become the player you are right now?
Biggest thing is probably motor, knowing to bring it every time, no matter who's out. Probably the biggest thing I learned. Just putting your stamp on the game, playing hard, and making sure people know who you are by the time you leave.
Obviously, you know, there was a lot of hype coming into this matchup. The number one team in the county, you guys, the number four team in Torrey Pines. What were you guys able to do, you know, to create that separation early? What was the game plan and how was it executed?
You know, we don't switch up any game. Every game is the same thing. We want to run, we want to get out, we want to dunk, we want to shoot. So we just came in and did what we do, and they got to adjust to us. So that's what happened.
All right, looking long term, you're going to UCLA next year. I mean, what are your goals and aspirations moving forward? I mean, obviously there's no timetable for when you want to get to the NBA, but obviously that's a goal. Talk to us a little bit about, you know, the future for you.
Yeah, the main goal is to be a pro. I want to be a pro. That's my main goal. But UCLA, obviously, want to get there, win a natty. You know, they're number two in the nation right now. I want to pick that up next year when I get there.
This location, this gym, you put on a performance against La Costa Caney to upset them in the American division. How nostalgic is it to be back in this gym, and now you're the MVP of the national division of the Under Armour Holiday Classic. Just talk about that journey.
Man, it's crazy, man. Every time I played on here the whole tournament, I thought about back to that game because it really helped me for my career. It really jump-started me. So it's very nostalgic. It's a beautiful thing to come back and win it all and get the MVP.
Talk a little bit about that game, I mean, that performance. You started off 2-for-10 from the field, and then all of a sudden you hit a couple of jump shots and everything started to change. What was your mentality, getting off to a little bit of a slow start for you? I mean, what was your mentality, to get out of that?
For me, I think my biggest improvement coming up is the fact that my mental game is strong. Mm-hmm. I know that I personally think I can make every shot I take. And even if I miss it, it doesn't really matter to me because I know I'm going to come back down and play the same way. So
really didn't affect me, so that really helped me to have a good mental standpoint.
What happened during that stretch in the last few seconds when you guys ceded a little bit of the control of the game and they kind of came back? I mean, what did you tell your guys during the timeouts? You know, what was going on in the huddle there?
Man, it gets a little hectic, so my thing in that situation, I don't want to add to the craziness. I want to be the solution to it. So I didn't really have to say anything to them. I just took it upon me to get the ball and make the last two.
Yeah. And those last two free throws, obviously, you know, split a pair, which led to them potentially being able to tie the game. They missed a couple. You came back. You hit two. How'd you feel when you went back to the line for those last two shots?
Missed the first one. Like I said, I think I'm going to make everything I take, so I knew I was going to make the next two. So I was happy I got a second chance at it.
37 points, MVP performance. What do you think this? What message do you think you're sending about your team, your region, to you know the rest of the country at large about San Diego basketball?
I don't want people to look at us in a down way or passion, like we're not passionate or tough. When people know we're tough, you know we beat teams from East Coast, Middle Coast, whatever you want to call it. We beat teams from everywhere. We're tough. I just want to let people know all over the world that San Diego's on the map.
Are you the top point guard in the country?
Yes, sir.
Without a doubt?
Yes, sir.
Got it. Are you the top prospect in the country?
I believe I am.
Confidence. He's got that confidence. And, yes, of course, we've got to ask. The shoes, man. What would the kids say a year ago? What are those?
These are human races, but I know he wants to talk about I wear a different shoe every game. Uh-huh. I like shoes. I have a lot of them, so I might as well wear all of them.
What's your favorite pair of basketball shoes that you own?
I don't have a favorite, but I'm an Adidas guy, so I'm rocking all the Adidas.
You rocking all
the Adidas? For now.
For now? What shoe are you looking forward to coming out the most? Little threes?
Probably.
Yeah. Those joints going to be hot.
Yeah, they're going to be tough.
Yep. All right. I think that's it, guys.
All right. 6'4" senior, number one, Jaylen
Yeah! joined on the court tonight by his mom, Ashanti, dad, Ronnie, and his sister, Jordan. In a single season, Jaylen is currently ranked fourth in school history and career points on a list that includes the top two career scorers in San Diego section history. Jaylen would like to thank his dad for all the work that he put into him since day one. Jaylen thanks his mother for her unconditional love and Jordan for being the best little sister he could have. And 6'4", senior number one All-American, Jaylen Hands.
Yeah!
it's a blessing. You know, Foothills Christian is a great school. We fight every game. Most of all, I'm thankful for all the San Diego coming out and watching this every day. Hopefully put on a show and we have some moments that you won't forget.
A lot of love for you in San Diego. Wherever you go in San Diego or outside the county, gyms fill up. They want to see you. They love watching you play.
Man, besides from the team, that's probably the best thing to see people cheer for me, people come to the games. You know, every game we had this year in San Diego was fun. It was almost packed, pretty much. So just to have everyone come out, talk to people after the games, it's a blessing. I'll never forget that part.
Final words, anything to San Diego fans out there, the prep fans, as you leave the court for the last time?
Thank you, San Diego. I love you. Don't forget about me.